Amy Hall, and in the next few slides, I will be presenting my research on a new drug called Ripasodil, evaluating its efficacy and safety in a particular set of glaucoma patients. I have absolutely no financial interests. So we all know that for the past 1.5 years, the whole world is facing the pandemic of COVID-19, which has hit the healthcare delivery system really hard. Patients suffering from various diseases are suffering a lot, and glaucoma patients are no exception to this. Situations becomes even worse for those who are on the verge of losing vision unless intervened actively with surgery or laser. But on a positive note, as a good news, Ripasodil, a member of new class of drug RHO kinase inhibitors, has recently been made available in India, though it was approved in 2014 itself. And since its approval, it has been evaluated as monotherapy or combination therapy in glaucoma patients with encouraging results. These RHO inhibitors work in glaucoma patients by various mechanisms like neuroprotection, decreasing scarring, increasing Doppler blood flow, and protecting the retinal ganglion cell itself, but of course, above all, IOP reduction. And their mechanism of lowering IOP is due to the modulation of cellular cytoskeleton in the subclavicular meshwork, and hence decreasing the outflow resistance in conventional pathway. This supposed mechanism is entirely different from what is available for other classes of these glaucoma medications. Hence, it can be hypothesized that it should fetch few more millimeter of IOP reduction over other medications. And with this research question in mind, we propose to evaluate the safety and efficacy and tolerability of Ripasodil in patients of glaucoma with inadequately controlled IOP with maximum medical therapy. Inadequately controlled implies the patients are not able to achieve their target IOP even on being the maximum tolerable medical management. Ethical clearance was taken, and a prospective non-comparative interventional case series study was designed at the Tertiary Eye Care Center from March 2020 to September 2020, the phase when the whole world was facing the first wave of COVID-19. Patients of open-angle glaucoma, more than 35 years of age, not achieving the target IOP as per Anderson classification despite treatment, but IOP less than 30 mm of FG, one included, but those with angle closure or secondary glaucoma, history of prior laser or surgery allergy, or congestion, visual acuity less than 2 by 200, or any severe visual field effects were excluded. After getting basic ophthalmic workup with maintaining COVID protocol, one drop of Ripasodil was instilled into the target eye twice daily in addition to the existing glaucoma regimen for 3 months, and follow-up was planned for first, second, and third month when applanation tonometry for IOP and slit-lamp examination was done for the patients. The patients were required to fill a questionnaire for any associated systemic symptoms, or if yes, then what was the time of onset and what was the duration of its persistence. Degree of IOP reduction after 3 months from the primary outcome measure, while the incidence of adverse event from the secondary outcome measure. So coming to the results, at the end of this study, we had a total of 42 eyes of 38 patients who completed the study and were analyzed. Mean number of medications before involvement 3.57 and a baseline IOP of 19.1 before standard deviation of 4.5 millimeter. It was found that a persistent decrease in IOP was noted at first, second, and third month. And these values were statistically analyzed during the tailed student test for this data to get the percentage reduction of IOP as compared to baseline. And it was found that the mean IOP reduction of -2.6, the percentage reduction at first month was 13.5%. And at third month, it was with a mean reduction of -4.2 millimeter of mercury. The finally, an IOP reduction in percentage of 16.8%. And target IOP was achieved in 18 eyes, which constituted 42.8% of our patients. As far as the adverse reactions are concerned, conjunctival condition was the most commonly encountered problem in 23 eyes. The congestion started within 15 minutes of drug instillation and it persisted for 1 to 2 hours, as reported by 92% of the patients. One patient reported blepharitis, but all these symptoms were mild and transient, requiring no other extra medications. And none of the patients dropped out of this study because of these complaints. Coming to the deemed with this literature, it has been found when Ripasodil is used as monotherapy, it has an IOP reduction of as high as 19.3%. But in combination with timolol and latanoprost, the IOP reduction found or mentioned in the literature is 17.2 and 13.8 respectively. A similar study evaluating it as an add-on therapy has documented a IOP reduction of 15.5, which is comparable to our study, which we got as an IOP reduction of 16.8%. Conjunctival congestion remains the most commonly documented side effect, with an incidence as high as 100% in one of the study. We got a percentage of 54.7% of conjunctival congestion in our patient. Some of the studies have reported keratitis as well, but we didn't get any patients of keratitis or any other visual thickening complaints. One patient reported blepharitis, which has also been mentioned in other studies. So at the end of the study, we can conclude that the additional use of riposodil is effective and well tolerated in patients who are already on maximum medical therapy. And it may help to avoid laser photoplastia glaucoma surgery for at least for short duration of time. Though we admit that small sample size and short duration of follow-up remains our shortcomings, and to get the final picture of long-term efficacy and safety of this drug, we need to have long-term comparative study and clinical trials. But at this point, we can definitely say that this new emerging drug therapy has given a ray of hope for these difficult patients in such difficult situations. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Rashmi. Professor Manadeep Singh, you want to ask anything?
Not really much in this, but the only thing is that as we know that every next drug that is added to the treatment gives less and less additive effect.
Absolutely.
So a drug which is used as monotherapy giving 17% and again as a fourth drug or a fifth drug giving the equivalent amount, I think this needs to be reassessed and further more bigger studies are required for this.
Dr. Shakeen Singh, any questions?
Any relation when you use it in with parasympathetic promotion drugs? Am I audible?
Dr. Rashmi, are you there?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir, I'm here. Can you repeat the question, sir?
So, any relation when it's used with parasympathetic promotion drugs?
No, not exactly. No. Not any typical